All right. Io Capitano. Io Capit. I don't know how to pronounce it. Directed by Matteo Garrone. Director I really like. And I think all the subtitles are hard-coded in this, but just in case they're not, I think I have a file for one of these subtitle things somewhere here. Let me just grab that. All right. So yeah, the subtitles I think are hard-coded in the thing that I have. But I have another file ready just in case I need to switch to it. But anyway, yeah, good director. Don't know anything about the movie. And here we go. 3, 2, 1. Lol Capitano, yeah. I thought it was an L when I saw the title first. I thought it was a lowercase L, but it wasn't. Shoe throwing, a classic. I'm trying to think if there's a foreign language film that I watched this year that I feel should be in the nominations, but I don't remember. Yeah, to freedom, maybe. Damn, that stash. Fallen Leaves, yeah, that's the one. Oh, about dry grasses, for sure, yeah.
I have to see that one.
It sounded like he was speaking French for a bit.
He was. There was a little bit of French in there.
Oh.
This is French.
Yeah. Yeah, the French did colonize a bunch of Africa. Batch. What does this shirt say? Yeah, Matteo Garrone is really good with visuals, so he's a director that I'll definitely just watch any movie he makes. Yeah, reality is fucking slept on, honestly. I like his hat.
True.
Yeah, also, if you go to France, you're going to be the subject of racism for sure. This is what I do to Gael and Scoop before every stream. All right. Well, what the f- I was wondering why About Dry Grasses wasn't nominated, and then I realized that Nuri Bilge Ceylan has not been nominated for an Oscar ever. Like, none of his films have. Isn't that insane?
Turkey
it
just
won the Palme d'Or.
Submit.
The Winter's Sleep won the Palme d'Or. You'd think that would be like a for sure the Academy at least like watches it. How could that be too long for them and then give like fucking 10 nominations for Killers of the Flower Moon, you know?
Once Upon a Time in Anatolia wasn't nominated?
I don't think so. I skimmed the pages and I didn't. Usually it just says if it's Oscar nominated mm-hmm. in the top. That's a crime. Maybe they just see that Turkey submitted it and they're like, nah.
Yeah.
Like, why would we watch this? Can't think of any other reason, honestly. I'll have to check if Turkey actually submitted any of his films.
Maybe Turkey just doesn't submit
Yeah, maybe
films.
It's an Anatomy of the Fall situation. Yeah, they do like Garone. So which country submitted this, though? Because sometimes a... I'll look it up after. Italy? That's funny.
Well, maybe this becomes a much more Italian movie for the next...
I don't know.
...hour and 40 minutes. It's possible.
I'm not sure. Yeah, after we watch this, I want to look up like what countries submitted what, because I'm kind of curious about that. Only one Turkish film nominated in the last 20 years called Mustang. Oh, I'll check it out at some point. Thanks, I'll leave a tab open. What kind of dollar? That's a sick ass dusty laptop. Sandy. They are woefully unprepared. I understand a good chunk of French. I'm shocked with how I've been able to learn it past school. Just by watching French movies and... No. What? Good catch. It's funny. Oh, I love this. What a great system. Oh, wow. Mustang is Turkish, but submitted by France. So it's, there is a real possibility that the Academy has never watched a film submitted by Turkey because they don't. It's not on their list of countries that they care about. Honestly,
it's not like, European enough.
I'm not even kidding. Like, there's. Yeah, I feel like there's certain Italy's, countries where they don't even like check.
Yeah, Italy submitted this movie so that it would get looked at.
Yeah. And then they voted for it so they could pretend like they watch movies from other
countries. We watch movies that aren't European ones, as long as they're submitted by Europe.
See, that's a real hashtag we should shame the Oscars over. Oscar is so Eurocentric. No, yeah, a woman in Montreal, like, asked to, like, borrow my cell phone to make a call to her brother, and I understood her. It was crazy. I could figure out what she needed. Just a random woman on the street. Does Canada submit Montreal films like every, or Quebec films every year, I guess? Has there been a Quebec film that's been nominated? I'm sure.
Right? I feel like probably, yeah.
Plastic bag first. Yeah. Almost forgot that part. Vincent D was nominated for foreign language. That's dope. It's always nice seeing a story that like has been tackled in so many different forms, but is just like so well realized and properly communicated. It's just a good director. I like how he's watching. He doesn't have to. You're holding hands after. Wow. Like, it's just a really nice looking film. Oh, fuck. That sucks. A Squid Game. Yeah, I guess he already got the money, so. There's a lot of really good shots in this movie. Imagine being like a desert guide, like knowing your way. Whoa. Oh no. Damn. What the fuck? I feel like you could fake drinking. They can't see you. You could totally fake drinking that. Although they're just, if they're just waiting for wait, all of them to shit, I guess. So. Say I haven't eaten in 3 days. Just farting. Well, I also feel like if they're the type of people that if you ask them to do something, they're going to do the opposite. Like, take me. Why would they do that?
They won't make any money. Do they still have a guide?
I don't know. I'm looking for... Ah, there he is. So what they should have done is build a secret compartment inside the shoe. Because they didn't thoroughly search the shoe. Shit. Fuck. It's fucking cool. Good deal. Yes. But then why would they free them if they're just such good labor? Good.
They can't let them go now.
You're never going to find another fountain maker like that ever again. You got to keep them. Good night, you're a boy. We still have time to make it an Italian movie. In the last quarter. I'm sure it will be. Way. Way.
Is this a Mario movie?
No pressure. Watch out for Lauren Southern. Do you know where you're docking? Or is that another boat? Pretty good. Pretty good.
Yeah. Yeah. I'd say that's great.
Yeah. I would as well. 10 minutes of credits.
It's because they're fancy, slow credits.
True. Matteo Garrone going to the Oscars, but they won't
cut
to him.
As an Italian movie.
Yeah, as an Italian. It was a very Italian movie. But they're not going to cut to him because nobody knows who he is. We won't see him on the broadcast. But
yeah,
he's there.
I don't know what he looks like. So I wouldn't recognize him even if they did cut to him.
The only scene that felt off to me was the, like, woman on the boat, like, oh, I gotta call the thing. It just, like,
the phone call scene, or the,
yeah,
pregnant woman.
The, I mean, the combination of the two. It just felt like a little much at that point, and he didn't feel as convincing in that shot as other scenes. But overall, I really liked it. They could have had that, yeah, like a... The pregnant woman just feels like a bit of a, like it was kind of tacked on a little. Because the rest of the conflict with the boat and the stakes involved, especially with like the engine poisoning people, already felt like pretty...
It was not needed.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, they definitely could have gotten away without it.
Yeah. I like how they get to say on the poster from the director of Pinocchio.
That'd be very helpful.
That's what on the IMDb poster it does say that.
Does it actually?
It says it in Italian, but yeah. Director of Gomorrah, Dogman, and Pinocchio. I liked Reality better than Gomorrah and Dogman.
Yeah, I haven't seen Dogman.
Dogman.
I liked Reality better than Gomorrah. Yeah. But I don't know. Gomorrah won some awards and was
Gomorrah was his
I think more well I did not like it as much as other people seemed to like it at the time.
Yeah, I don't know. It was like a huge movie that I wasn't like huge on. As in it was huge and like it got like an immediate Criterion release and Martin Scorsese was pimping it out and
yeah. I thought it was good.
Yeah, it was good. But I wasn't like maybe I could revisit it. Reality slept on for sure.
Yeah, Reality is really good.
Trying to decide between a 7 or an 8. I could give it a high 7 for now, maybe.
Yeah, I think that's fair. Yeah. A 7.8.
Where did I get a copy of Io Capitano? Well, I went to a restaurant with many chefs and I ordered a tortilla that myself and many other customers ate.
There were lots of chefs and they prepared your
there
food
was a,
rapidly.
There were enough chefs for the tortilla.
So, Teacher's Lounge gets the win today?
Which is weird.
It's close for me. Like, honestly, I could take either one of those movies.
I feel like this had more... Like, the parts in this movie that were good were better than any part in Teacher's Lounge. But Teacher's Lounge was
just a little
more consistent and digestible and shorter and didn't have as many kind of... You know, it didn't have any real moments where I was like, it didn't lose me at any point. Mm-hmm. Whereas this kind of like almost lost me at points. This is a better directed film. But Teacher's Lounge is just kind of easier to give it an 8. Where...
I liked both a lot, yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't like either one as much as what's the foreign language? Is it Anatomy of a Fall?
No, because France didn't submit
France,
it.
It's zone, of
zone of interest.
Yeah, zone of interest.
And then submitted by which country? We'll find this out in a second after the credits are done here.
That'd be fun. I think I bet you it's the UK that submitted.
It's probably
zone
the UK,
of
yeah, because it's
they get to
Mr. Glazer. Yeah.
They still get to do it even though they're just English.
Yeah, I watched Teacher's Lounge off stream because my parents were over and it was a thing that I could do socially with them because they just showed up in town today and I didn't feel like being like, I'm watching a movie on the internet instead of saying hi. They just finished a long trip in their motorhome in the States and are passing through Vancouver right now, and so I didn't want to ignore them.
And then the last two are Society of the Snow and...
Oh, yeah, that was international. Yep.
And then there's one other one.
Yeah, what's the other one? Let's find out.
Is it... It's not El Conde, is it?
No. That one, that was nominated for cinematography, but not,
and nothing else.
I do want to... I really want to see that. How was it? You watched it?
I watched it.
Not great? Pablo's hit or miss, but I like him enough that I feel like I should watch his movies.
I enjoyed this a lot more. I think I enjoyed this a lot more. And, you know, even from a cinematography standpoint, like, it was nice. It was well shot. It just... I kind of want something to be, like, its
it was
own
perfect
style.
Days. It was the Wim Wenders. Perfect Days.
Perfect Days.
Yep. Sorry, it wasn't... Was it its own style, is what you were saying?
I don't know. For me, it wasn't. It didn't, I wouldn't watch and say, oh yeah, no, this movie like sort of is what it is. It feels like it could be other things too, you know. I don't know. Wasn't my favorite, but it also wasn't hard to watch. It was better than Maestro, but that's a low bar.
Maestro is the lowest bar. Have I tried the Fable Pinocchio gum yet? No, it's in Atlanta right now. I will eat the Pinocchio gum, the forbidden Pinocchio gum. I will at some point. That was really good. Garone? When's the last time he made a movie? Actually, I did watch a movie from him somewhat recently that wasn't like amazing, but I still liked it. Let's see. I don't even know if I'm pronouncing his name close to correct. I've never looked it up. Okay, I'm going to memorize this face for the Oscars broadcast and see if he... He's got a weird face.
He looks way different than I expected him to look.
Mm-hmm.
It's because I feel like... He was going to look like Roberto Benigni. It's because all Italian filmmakers look like that to me. Until they get until I actually see them, that's how I imagine them.
Yeah, there's Matteo. It has to be Matteo, not Matteo. Matteo makes more sense now that I say it. Matteo Garrone. I'm going to check out the international submissions. Give me a second. I'm just going to look at his filmography. Yeah, I gave Gomorrah a 6 when it came out. I was not wowed by it. Tale of Tales was the most recent one that I was not wowed by, but like I still liked it. It was still definitely worth watching. Yeah, it was really interesting. Pinocchio, I feel like I could bump to like an 8 maybe on a second watch. It was really good. I'd be down to see that again. Yeah, I like him. I like him a lot. I'll definitely watch any feature that he makes. I guess I've never given him... Oh, Reality was an 8. Reality is my only 8 that I've given him, I guess. Everything else was like a little... Just a little tiny. Almost there. But... Yeah, Reality is definitely slept on. Everybody should watch it. Less than 6,000 ratings. And the rate 6.8 out of 10, I feel like that's like disturbing. Why people just, I don't know why people
a little
don't
bit mean, maybe.
I think this film's fucking awesome. I've seen this a bunch.
It's kind of fun.
It's great. I love like character kind of pieces. Yeah. All right. BRB. I'm going to pee and then we're going to check out the international submissions. Hold on.